Boom, baby. All right, here we go. Gonna be painting a portrait of sorts. Just going with the idea of the Lone Ranger. See what happens. It's very difficult for me to stick with one subject, one style. You know, maybe it's a bad thing. I move around too much with different subjects and different styles. You know, sometimes I'll do a little series of a few things that are similar on the same subject, and then I'll move to something else. Well, I guess a lot of people do that. But this, I'm just planning on doing just a little portrait type thing. Not really a portrait, but a human figure, human face. Just picking out what brushes I'm gonna need here. I usually don't use too many. I'll just use a few. I guess that's enough. All right, so the colors I have laid out are simply viridian green, ultramarine blue, titanium white, cadmium red, cadmium yellow, and black. Very primary. I've been keeping it very primary. Take a little blue to get us going. Now, the main feature of this painting is pretty much the hat. I want to take up a decent amount of space on the canvas, fill the page, if you will. That's what one of my early art teachers would say, you know, fill the page. Don't leave any empty negative space, at least not too much. Of course, that's not always the case. Sometimes the painting will call for more negative space. Just laying in those basic shapes. Not really copying any picture in particular. It's just sort of an imaginative exercise. Please excuse the banging. There's renovations taking place upstairs. And yes, I do mean in the apartment above me. Now, a lot of times, gallerists will tell you, at least I've heard this before, that that people want to match paintings with their couch and whatnot. You know. But I say, fuck it. They can get their couch to match my painting. How about that? This painting is a little bit absurd. It is what it is. It's just the beef brisket in the oven, don't worry. Sometimes the painting just does what it wants to do. That's fine. Sometimes you just need to let the painting do what it wants to do. We just need to kind of let it come out naturally. Anyways. Now the mask is black. I guess that looks reasonable for the time being. But I need more out of it. How far can we push it? You know what I mean? How far can we push it? I don't even necessarily care what form this painting takes on. I'm kind of interested to just see what happens with it. Why not just make the whole thing a little bigger? Who cares if it goes out of frame? Just add a little more dimension to it. Screw it. All right. Who is the man behind the mask, you might ask? The answer is, I don't think we're supposed to know. Let it be a mystery. Just let it be a mystery. Try to give a little highlight to the nose, a little definition to the face. Yeah, I think I'm gonna come back in with the black and get the mask under control. Yeah, guy has a nose. Shape out the lips, face. Highlight on the chin. Yeah. All right, now let's get serious with this face mask thing. All right. No, those are not sunglasses. I hope they don't look like sunglasses. Now, sometimes I just go with black lips and it works. Just paint the lips black. No one's gonna even notice. For whatever reason. What angle is this guy coming at us from? We don't really know. And I don't think it even really matters. You know? Really doesn't. Get back in there with that black, reestablish those lines a little bit. Just reestablish the shape of the hat. Very nice. Good. All right, now. And that brush off. Be good if I had a towel. Pick up some more white. Go back to town with the said white, add some highlights. Use that to soften some things. And make that head a bit more shape to it. And the ear, I forgot about the ear. Little ear action. Definitely need some highlights on the hat. So this, I suppose, is an interesting little piece. Let's see if we could add some details to the eyes. Or should I keep him more of a phantom? Now those look like goggles or something. We need more white. All right, more white. I feel like Freddy Krueger holding these damn brushes. Alright. Just get some nice white on the brush. Get in there with some nice highlights. Did I just ruin the painting? That's all right. Just fix it up a little bit. Alright, desperate times call for desperate measures. I'm just gonna lay some eyes in there. Screw it. Alright, a little cartoony. But it doesn't matter. Just go with it. It's not really your job to even judge your own painting. To some degree, of course. Yeah, you're going to be your own worst critic. But ultimately, the world that judges it. Just got a little more shadow here. Maybe I'll add a mustache to this son of a bitch. This guy looks a little ridiculous. Let's be real. I'm gonna have to add. First of all, definitely gonna add to those, to the mask. I might seriously give him a mustache. How would that look? This is a completely absurd painting. But we must tarry on. We must tarry on. See if we could save it from sure destruction. Somewhat interesting, I suppose. I think that just about sums it up. I'll probably do some more work to it once the paint dries. Or you know what, I'll just do it now. Why wait? Why put it off to tomorrow when it could be done today? But this is gonna be rapid fire. Warning you. Those bastards up there have been making a ruckus all day long. good, or should we go even harder? That's a little bit crazy. But we've already made it this far, we can't turn around now. Alright, I think that makes for sort of an interesting composition. Do you agree with that? Something a little different. Verges on verges on something, I'm not quite sure what. Alright, now we're getting into the danger zone. We gotta be careful here. This hat might have just gotten completely out of control. Now it could go on infinitely. Back in with the white blue. Can y'all hear that music? The music and all those noises coming from upstairs. Having a real party. Doing renovations. Alright. This guy is just started to pop out at us. And that's why even when the painting looks like shit, you just gotta keep going. Because it actually can get better. You know, can get better. So just don't give up on it. Certainly interesting. Maybe I'll go around everything with some white. Yeah, let's do that. Forget about it. I'm just gonna put that white directly on there. Not gonna worry about it. Just squeeze some white out. That little brush. This will do. And just spread it around. It's just thick titanium white. Would be nice if we had a little medium to thin it out a little bit, but I don't even think it's necessary. Just clean up those edges. I've been kind of wanting to be, I've been wanting to use thicker brush strokes. You know, really put some paint on there so you can, really it looks like a painting. Especially this day and age of flat digital screens and digital photography everywhere, digital images everywhere. I think it's nice to see a painting with some real visceral material to it. You know, it has that handmade look. It has, some real material sense to it. You could tell it really exists in the physical world, not just on a computer. I'm just gonna tilt this up on the edge here. So I can get the bottom edge more easily. Now, yes, this is not the most economical way to paint. It does use a lot more paint. kind of the price you pay for quality. But it just really cuts those edges so nicely. Really makes the object pop out. Here, you're gonna try to do just a bit more here. I think that's all right. Put a little bit more up top. Yeah, painting with thick layers of oil paint is always interesting. And this really is not even that thick, all things considered. Compared to some other painters I could think of. You know, some people go absolutely wild with it. That's another thing. See, I wasn't really planning or expecting to use thick paint, but sometimes that happens. I think it looks pretty dandy. Sure. Let it be. Maybe I will just come back through there a little bit. Just to sort of square the circle, so to speak. Alright, I think I'm gonna pretty much call it quits. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for dropping by. This thing is gonna be available on the internet. Very soon, ebay.com. Michael Mercogliano, artist at large. You could search me on the Instagrams, on the tubes, on the eBay. Check out what I'm doing. See some neat painting action. In action. And that's about it. Thank you. Thank you. Hope you enjoy. Have a wonderful weekend. Even though today is Tuesday. Thank you. Have a good night.